Okay, I'm going to talk about this turkey. Now, kind of a mechanical looking monster here. This is what we call an economizer. Now, it's got gears and it's got dampers and stuff going all over the place. Now, I'm going to explain how all these work, and maybe I'll see if I can get it running and a few things like that for you. But this first one is just going to be about what it is and why we use it. These are used mostly in commercial applications, and there's a little something happens with commercial air conditioners. Because buildings have quite a bit of internal heat, that means copy machines, computers, people, all these things that wander around in buildings, lights, that sort of stuff, they actually make quite a bit of heat. So air conditioners used in these commercial spaces oftentimes have to cool at temperatures that you wouldn't think they would have to. It is not terribly unlikely that you would have an air conditioner operating at a 45 degree outdoor temperature, because the inside load and possibly some solar load from windows will actually increase the temperature inside the structure to the point where you do need air conditioning. Well, why am I air conditioning, running a compressor, using up gobs of power, when I could simply use outside air? If the air is 45 degrees, that's not too far off of what the supply air temperature is going to be on an air conditioner. So couldn't I use that outside temperature to cool the structure? That's what these things are all about. There's a few parts on them I'll go over. I'm going to go over this more later in future videos, but these are the dampers. They rotate back and forth. Here is a motor that it's a mod motor, and it is set up to move the dampers different ways to allow certain amounts of outside air into the structure to provide this cooling. There's a few things about these type of things and what they'll do to inside air pressures and the like we'll all have to go over. But for right now, let's just say I am going to bring in outside air to cool my structure rather than use the compressor to cool it, because this is more or less free. This is mounted on the return air of, oftentimes these are rooftop units, package rooftop units, and they'll be mounted on the return air, and they will adjust to move certain amounts of air to get the desired temperature that you're looking for inside the structure. That's all I'm going to go on this right now. The next one, I'm going to have a little diagram and show kind of how this works, and then we'll play with this thing and see if we can get it to work. That's all on this one.